It's a good signing. It's a good signing. You see, De Ligt is a good defender. He's a good defender that tends to have certain bozo moments. Now, let me be fair here. His previous season for Bayern was actually pretty good. And many people pushed for him to actually start a lot more games than he actually did. So, yes, he's had bozo moments. Obviously, the biggest one was, of course, at the previous Euros. But overall, he's still a young defender. Remember, he burst onto the scene very young, and we're going to get there. And I do feel that, if you don't tell me, this good signing or bad signing, this is a good signing for United. It's a good signing for United, especially when you just look at their defender situation and how that has been. This is a good signing. And what makes this even a better signing is this. So when a manager is buying players, it's not just about buying good players. No. People say, oh, no, just buy a good player. No. Good players, yes. The right players. You can buy an average player that fits into your system. Or you could buy an amazing player that doesn't fit into your system that you don't know how to coach. So it is better for a manager to buy a pretty good player who he knows how to coach and knows how to use effectively than buying an outstanding superstar player that he doesn't know how to coach and does not fit into his philosophy. Case in point, that Ajax team that should have made it the UCL final, they should have, in that crazy 2019 run where they beat Real Madrid on their way, playing some amazing football, beating Real Madrid, beating Juventus, and De Ligt scoring against Juventus. That was how he burst into the scene. People are like, wow, this 19-year-old defender who is the captain of this side, look at just how assured he is on the ball and just how mature and advanced he is as a defender for so young. Guys like, wow, this guy is money. And who was the coach? It was Ten Hag. So what makes this even better, beyond him just being a very talented defender who can get better and improve, is Ten Hag knows him, Ten Hag coached him, and Ten Hag was the manager that brought him into the world on the biggest club stage, which is the UCL. So this is a very good situation and a very good basis to start off with for Man United. And let's keep it a stack. So first of all, obviously, you have a situation where Varane is leaving. So he's going to be on the free. And look, shout out to Varane. Loads of injuries. Clearly wasn't the Varane that we saw at his peak, which was around the 2017-2018, where he obviously helped Real Madrid win a few UCLs and, of course, the World Cup as well. But look at that FA Cup final. He was money. Like, that FA Cup final was a great way to bow out in terms of just reminding us what a peak of Varane was able to do and just how good of a defender he could be. But the issue is too many injuries, age tax, he just wasn't going to be consistent. So it's very clear that you need a younger, fresher defender for the next 5, 6, 7 years at Man United. But beyond just that, now, I believe this was like a true stat, that Man United had like the most different pairings of central defenders within the league. Someone needs to fact check like what the number was. It was something like 20 or 30. Because I remember, I think they were playing Arsenal. I think they said like Arsenal had 2 or 3 different centre-back pairings. And United had like 20 or 25, which is freaking insane. Anybody who knows football will know that. One thing you never change. And this is more than anything. Guys, this is more than anything. One thing you never change is a centre-back pairing. Ideally, the four. So whether it's a 4 or a 3, you never change that. Anybody who plays football will know that the most important aspect of the back line is communication. 100%. So beyond just your positioning, your ability to win your 1v1 tackles, your anticipation, the main thing is communication, because it's about when do we play the offside trap, when do we step up, who goes forward, who goes back, zonal, man-to-man, marking your men, knowing when we now have to do like a go for two guys to go to a guy. And if two guys go to a guy, cover that extra space. Okay, this wing has gone through. Let's now cover his space. All that is communication. And the key thing is, the best communication is when you have a consistent relationship. You can't have a consistent relationship when you keep changing your centre-back pairings. So, United, they've been unlucky. Because too many injuries. So what United are hoping that with a De Ligt is a guy who's young and a guy who hopefully doesn't have as many injury issues as, let's say, Varane has had or Martinez has had. So, look, 100%, I mean, because when you look back at some of United's great defenders, United had amazing defenders. You think of Dennis Irwin. You think of Pallister. I think Pallister was a defender, but definitely Irwin. Obviously, Rio, Vidic, Stam. Like, I'm one of those guys that believe that Rio Ferdinand is one of the best defenders I've ever seen. And funny you say Rio, De Ligt is like Rio. Because, you see, it's the modern game. And now, I don't feel everyone should do this, but this is Ten Hag's philosophy. Ten Hag is a guy where, no, I'm Dutch. I'm from the Cruyff lineage. I believe in total football. So my defender has to be good on the ball. One thing with De Ligt, whether you can say he has the Bozo gene, sometimes he makes a mistake, he is very good on the ball. He's very composed on the ball. So unlike Maguire, who plays like a fridge, De Ligt is very confident in bringing the ball up. Great balance, great composure, great ball control, knows how to pick a pass, plays with his head up, and can run straight into that midfield. So if you now pair him with a Martinez and then now form a relationship, you could form a very strong defensive foundational basis to now really say what's up. So, and also from De Ligt's point of view, and I've been reading that he actually does want this move, and it makes sense. Because we've heard even from rumblings of how he's not been happy to be benched. And he's not happy holding the bench, specifically for whether it's been Dier or Upamecano. And then he said, no, I want to be in a team where I am the consistent starter. So from De Ligt's point of view, boom. Because one stumbling block was, well, there's no UCL football, bro. Abang, you're guaranteed. But he says, no, he doesn't mind. And I agree with that because you're going to be very well paid. It's my answer, you're going to be very, very well paid. That's one. Second thing is consistently playing. Think about this. What would you rather have? Play for a team that's in the UCL, but you're not guaranteed to start. Play for a team that's not in the UCL, but do have the resources to gain players and tools to get back into in the UCL, plus you are guaranteed to be a starter. With Varane out, with Maguire being a fridge, if De Ligt stays fit, he starts every game. Oh, and I forgot to add, you have the trust of your manager. Because I think that is a key factor. Ten Hag knows him. They know each other, like they're both Dutch. They're both Dutch, they both work under each other, and Ten Hag knows him. No, I know him. Just as he knew Martinez, no, I know him. So therefore, I trust him. And that is a very key thing because remember, we can't forget the human aspects of these things. So if there's a manager who you've worked under and had a good relationship with, you know that even when the going gets rough, I'm going to have my back. So if I make a mistake, I have a bad game, he's not going to throw me under the bus or something. He's going to give me a second, third, fourth chance. You don't get a second, third, fourth chance with a manager who you've not worked with. So for me, look, for United, I think it's a really good signing. I think it's a really good signing. And I think for De Ligt, he would be disappointed that he didn't really get given a chance to really hold down a position at Bayern. But look, it is what it is. Because the most important thing for any player is to always play. So if I'm a manager, if you're Koeman now, or we're now looking at now the World Cup, we're looking at things. If you're not playing, how can I pick you? So you could... I'm not going to just pick you because, oh, you're in a team that plays in the UCL. Okay, you're in a team that plays in the UCL. Are you playing? If not, who cares? Okay, you don't play in the UCL, but you're playing the Premier League, one of the most watched leagues in the world. And you're playing consistently, and you're playing consistently well, boom, you're in. You're in. So for me, for De Ligt, it makes sense. And I think, you know, it's a good move for Ten Hag because next season is a bigger season for United and for Ten Hag because you are definitely on the clock, bro.